Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we are going to see about what is Azure and what is cloud computing is. Without wasting time, let's begin our today's video. So Azure is a cloud computing service created by Microsoft for building, testing, deploying, and managing applications and services through Microsoft managed data centers. I hope you are a little bit confused about the definition. Let's try to understand what is cloud computing is, then we'll come back to this definition. So what is cloud computing? Cloud computing is the on-demand delivery of IT resources over the internet with pay-as-you-go pricing, okay? Meaning like you have IT resources, it can be your servers, it can be your softwares, it can be your any kind of platforms you have. So those things are considered as IT resources, okay? That is available in the internet and you can pay as you go pricing. So you no need to purchase it. Instead, you whenever you use it, you pay for it, right? It's like hiring that softwares. Let's try to understand a little much better. Instead of buying, owning, and maintaining the physical data centers, okay, and servers, you can access technology services such as computing power, storage, and databases on an as and needed basis from cloud providers. So this is what a cloud computing is. So you no need to own any physical data center. So you are already a working professional. You might have aware like how a data center will look like. It will be a huge servers, and the data center people, the infrastructure people, will configure based on different projects need. They will configure the servers, right, and with different configurations. And it can be a database, and it can be some kind of storages, right? So these are the things, if you own a company, you need to maintain it, everything. So instead of you maintain it, what you can use it like, all these services or all these hardware capabilities are available in the internet. You go and use that one. You can purchase it. I need this particular server. I need this SQL server software for some period of time. Then you can use that one. Once you are done, you can give it back to the internet providers or the cloud providers, right? So this is what a concept behind cloud computing is. So who are those cloud providers? Azure. So Microsoft is the provider with the name of Azure, and AWS is another famous cloud computing technology by Amazon. Google has its own cloud services, IBM, Alibaba. These are different cloud providers. Basically, I didn't mention the company name, the cloud technology names, right? So these are different cloud providers. So this is what the core logic behind the cloud computing is. Then we come back to this definition now. So Azure is a cloud computing service created by Microsoft. So it's a cloud computing service by Microsoft for building, testing, deploying, managing applications. So as an end user, we don't want to own any server. I don't want to purchase any server. Instead, I will go to Microsoft Azure portal. Then I will like choose some of the resources. I will create some resources. And whenever I use for 1 month or 2 months, I will pay Microsoft only for my usage. Then I will be billed only for how much I have utilized, right? So this is what cloud computing is, and all these services are Microsoft managed data centers. So each cloud providers have a massive data centers and they will manage everything. You only use their computing power or storage or these services, right? This is what the core concept behind cloud computing, and Azure is one of the cloud computing service. With this note, let us try to see some of the benefits once you have cloud computing. So cost wise, it will be much cheaper than you procure. Like once you are a startup or any small organization, purchasing the server and database or any computing power is too much costly, because you are doing some POC or any new projects coming in, you purchase high-end servers, right? And then the project is not through, right? So you cannot replace that. Just like that, you can give back, right? Based on the service level agreements between the client, you can do that. But still, a lot of time it will not happen. So in those cases, when you have a cloud service, when you get a project, just use that one. Once it is dropped, then you release those resources. You are not going to be charged for long period of time, so even if it's 1 month. So cost wise it is more effective when you do not have a very good plan in the futures, or your projects are very tentative. So global scale. So you can scale, you can develop from any location. You can scale it across different location. It's not local to your particular location. Obviously, you need some setups. Then performance-wise, it will be tremendous improvement. I mean, initially, there will be a lot of hookups, but now it was very efficient. So security is taken care by Microsoft. It will be very speed, productivity, reliability. So productivity in the sense, like we will focus much on our development of the applications, right? We will not much focusing on maintaining the servers, patching, some hacking is happening, you need to protect it, all the patches you need to manually, you no need to worry about it, anything. You mostly focus on the development of your application and you focus on your business. And reliability, like you can trust always, because they are the providers and they have a very good infrastructure and encryption mechanism for storing data, and even once you retrieve. So all these benefits you will get in cloud computing. I hope this is fair enough to understand what is cloud computing is, why people are going towards cloud, and this is the on demand or niche skill for this decade, and most of the companies is going towards Azure or cloud computing technologies. So it's a right time to start learning these technologies. So with this note, let's stop this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button to learn the concepts in Azure. Do remember that data is asset.